Escúchame, a ver.
Hi Altrincham, how are you doing? That was a totally unprofessional start, wasn't it?
You fell into that seat.
Oh dear.
Hi everyone, how are you Altrincham?
It worked in the end. You're suffering the same problems that I suffer when I'm doing this. Everybody, say hello.
Hi.
Say hello to Kate. I can't decide whether it was Kate or Katie.
Kate.
So, say hi to the new girl, Kate. How are you, Kate? What have you been up to?
Oh, I'm really good today. I do have to apologise. I've just come from teaching adult ballet, so do ignore me. I'm going to get in the shower after this and have my dinner. What have I done today? I've been out and about in Altrincham. Anyone who's seen the teaser up on the page, I was in Toast. I had lunch there today with a friend. It was really good. I had the butternut squash and goat's cheese salad. It's £7.50, but it was really beautiful. And they've got a garden area, and then you go in, it's actually heated the garden area as well. It's pretty, it's beautiful, it's got music blaring out. Then you go inside of it, it's just, it's got the old structure of the, was it the NatWest building?
Was it Barclays?
Was it Barclays?
It was, yeah.
It's got the old architecture there and the murals on the wall, and it's just really nice. It's a lovely atmosphere. They've lowered the ceiling there.
Keep
the heat.
Are you sure you're not just taller?
Yeah, I'm grown. I do live in the country.
I've
lots
not
of
been
manure.
In. I've not been in, but I've had a look. I've had a quick nosy as I passed, and it still looks like a bank to me.
Yeah, beautiful though. And I did go on Grand Tees as well, just for you, Mr. Oldfields. Yeah, it's very warm in there actually. You can tell winter's coming, everyone's got the heating on in all the shops.
Yeah, it's a bit chilly out there tonight, isn't it?
It is, so ruffle warm people.
Anyway folks, if you'd like to join in tonight, please do with the comments, a couple already. Or you could try giving us a call. We'll give this a try again. The number you need is 07874 055611. Give us a call, talk about whatever you want, or pick us up on something we're saying here tonight.
What subjects do you want to talk about in Altrincham specifically? Maybe what's happening in the precinct, Greenwood Street is Greenwood, the clothes shop has it's clothes shut down. I'm babbling my words, I'm dinner, I'm really sorry. Greenwood's, I'm sure it's Greenwood's.
It is Greenwood's.
The one with the beautiful wedding dress in. Yeah, I love that wedding dress.
My dad needs to take a...
I know my dad's got two coats from there.
It's an old man's place.
It's not like a spring chicken.
Maybe I'm just feeling old today. It's been one of those days.
But yeah, what do you want to see there? And why are all these shops closing down? What's your opinion on it? And also, we put a post up specifically about house prices in Altrincham as well. Average price being about £450,000. What are your thoughts on that? Is it basically because it's an affluent area? Is it too expensive? What do you think? I'd love to hear what you think about that.
Yeah, please let us know. What people have been saying in the meantime is Marie Betty Davis says, hi Kate, bringing a touch of glamour to Altrincham.
Marie, thanks very much.
Very much.
I'm a sweaty mess at the moment. I know I shouldn't say that, but I am. I've been teaching.
Chris Jackinson, hi buddy, thanks for being there again tonight. Chris,
hi
to you. One of our regulars, Chris. Top guy. We keep trying to meet up with him, arranging me. But it all seems to fall through last minute, but he's promised us next time, so...
Brilliant.
Look forward to seeing you there, Chris.
Yep, same here.
And Craig is referring to you as some new eye candy.
Oh, thank you. And you know what? I've got my bins on. I've only got a little lippy on. Thanks, guys. I feel dead good about myself right now. Big up to the beautiful ladies out there in Altrincham.
So, Kate, you were... went somewhere, didn't you, recently?
I did. So I'm doing research on things in Altrincham for people, especially you know, groups all around the area, for people who are new to the area. I've got my notes here, so you'll have to bear with me. It's basically for people who feel the social life is lacking a bit. You know how your friends grow up, they have children, you know, they go married, they get married, and they just don't go out as much as they used to. Some people feel a bit lonely. It's like, where's all my friends gone? I've had friends that's happened to, and one in particular it's happened to. She's only just moved to the area, and all her friends have just gone and got married, except me. So Christmas season's approaching, and she just doesn't want to cling on to all my friends, even though I'd more than happily have her. So basically, she did a bit of digging online for groups, you know, fitness classes, socials with other mums, and she found a group called Meetup. Now, have any of you guys heard of Meetup at all? It was quite new to me, to be honest. So basically, I'll tell you about it. It's an umbrella organisation. It houses many different types of groups for all ages. It's, you know, groups like socialising, I've got down here fitness, dance classes, classes in various other genres, book clubs, gaming groups, just going out to places, and some people go away on holidays and all sorts. There's a small charge for some of these groups because they have to cover the cost of keeping this group up, while others are free and can just turn up to them to do some great events. So, this particular meetup that I'm going to plug tonight is called the Altrincham Hail and Sail Social Meetup. And it's run by a lady called Caroline. She's just taken the group over from someone else. The group has basically bloomed under her. Absolutely wonderful. So I went along to a meeting last Saturday to see what this was about. Now, it wasn't in Altrincham's particular meetup, but it was at the bridge in Dane Road. I went to speak to Caroline and the group members, and also my friend was at this group. I'm going to tell you about Caroline. She's a positive lady, a very positive lady. She's extremely passionate about a group, very welcoming and very inclusive. So I interviewed her about what the group was about. You can read that tomorrow because I'm going to drop this interview on the page tomorrow at some point around morning, midday, on the Facebook page, so you get to see all what it's about with pictures. So these events that she puts on in the group, usually around Hale, Altrincham, Timperley area, maybe Sale as well sometimes, and they usually meet, you know, meals out at pre-selected venues and can go for drinks. You do have to book your place on these meetups. It seems like a really scary idea doing this, meeting up with, you know, most people think, oh my god, a load of randoms. I was lucky, I went with a friend to this, so I met some people there as well, and I got to speak to them, but there were a lot of people turning up who didn't know anyone, and this was the scary bit. And I said to them, how do you feel about coming to this? And they were like, I'm terrified at first. 5 minutes in, that's it, everyone's fine, everyone's chatting, they've got over the nerves, and people just seem to gel, and you know, they're there for various reasons. So basically, you know, asking people, why are they there? Mainly it's moving to a new area, the friends had got married, had kids, one person had lost the partner, they'd lost the wife, which was very sad. They needed to get out, they needed to start meeting new people, and it was just, you know, wanting to get on with their lives. And people have formed friendships, like really good friendships through these types of meetups. They meet outside of the group. But all I can say about it is it's so inclusive. You're going to read about it tomorrow anyway on the Facebook site if you're interested. Just a little bit of information about Meetup. It's quite poignant. It actually came from America when 9/11 happened. You know, when the Twin Towers came down, people couldn't find each other. So someone set up Meetup so, you know, anyone could get in touch with anyone. We could put posts, have you seen such and such a person? Very sad, really. But it grew into a social group, and it's actually spread to the UK and beyond. So it's done a lot for people, getting people out of the houses, helping people who are lonely. So I think it's a really good group for people who, you know, who need to kind of
themselves. I know that lonely feeling can be so debilitating.
Yeah.
And it's such a mountain to climb.
Definitely.
To take that step.
Definitely.
That's all it is, just one step. But
there's
when you take them, it feels so much better.
Yeah.
Always feels so
much better. I'm going to go to another one of these to check these out for you guys. The group, again, is the Altrincham Hail and Sail social meetup. It's not just that meetup, by the way, when you sign up to the meetup group. It's absolutely free to sign up to it. There are plenty of other groups out there for specifically tailored for just women, women of a certain age, over, say, 40, 50, girls who are younger, men and women together, dating, going for walks, going on holiday. And so, you know what? There's millions of people who have joined these groups. And they just seem to thrive. And it's the same people that keep going to these groups. It's worth checking it out and seeing what you can see. But I can recommend Altrincham Hail and Sail Meetup. Caroline, I can't speak highly enough of her. She is so welcoming to people. It's really worth it. And as you said, people who have got loneliness issues, or, you know, they've got no one there at Christmas, you don't need to be like that. You can get out and find people. So, yeah, have a go. If you're feeling particularly lonely, go. You might see me at one. I might even bring Andy to one. I could even bring Chris. Meet us all. The Altrincham
team. Hi, Chris, by the way.
Hi, Chris. How are you? I hope you're having a lovely holiday. Hi, Joanne. I think they are having a lovely holiday.
I believe so, yeah.
Yeah. So, beautiful in Cornwall. I am particularly jealous of that at the moment.
So watch out for that post on the, it'll be appearing on the page at some point around winter, I guess?
Yeah, so, around there. So Caroline's going to explain it better than I can. She, you just have to come to a group and meet her and you'll understand about it much better, but fantastic person, really worth going to.
So a little bit of lunchtime reading. Little bit of support as well for you, of Craig Everett again.
Thank you,
Not only does he think you were eye candy, as he said earlier, he says professional too.
Oh, thank you.
Great recruit.
Oh,
we agree, Craig. Isn't she fantastic?
I'm going to blush.
Caroline saying thank you for that plug.
Caroline, you're very welcome. Ladies and gentlemen, Caroline's actually on the post now. You know what, thank you very much for the interview that you did for me. It is so insightful, and I think if people go to this group with Caroline, you're going to meet Caroline and you'll see how warm and welcoming she is. She is an asset to that group. Really, try the group, it's worth it.
Get yourselves down there, and thank you for joining us, Caroline.
Yeah, definitely, thank you. Right, so I've got a bit about Halloween and bonfire, so... Alright, I'm a big animal person. Keep your animals safe on bonfire and Halloween. I'm going to say this because around this time last year in the Timperley area, did anyone ever see any posts about Alfie the missing Jack Russell? It was a little Jack, black and white one. I think he must have been about 8 or 10 years old, an old dog. Basically, letting your animals off your leads when you're in a park, it's not worth it because people are setting off fireworks all the time. And this is what happened when Alfie's owner took him to the park. He left him off the lead for a runabout, obviously to do what he needs to do. And some idiot basically set off a load of fireworks late at night and Alfie ran off. And there was a big team of us. We had a page for the missing Alfie. We never found him, unfortunately. And hopefully he's out there somewhere and someone's looking after him. This is what happens if you don't keep your animals on the lead, because you have some very selfish people who like to let off fireworks late at night and keep everyone awake. I've seen posts about that on certain
Not
sites.
That.
It isn't. It isn't. Especially when you've got small children trying to get to sleep as well.
Yeah.
And, you know, trying to get up for school. But yeah, just keep your animals safe, please, people. If you want any information on how to keep them safe, if you're unsure what to do, let me know. I will put a post up on how to do that. I'm probably going to put a post up anyway on just ideas how to keep them safe.
It's the right thing to do.
It is the right thing to do. It's probably a post you've seen year after year, but it's worth just checking. Just a reminder as well, the Warhorse competition. It's not a lie.
Oh, yes.
It's not a lie, we have the tickets here.
Freebies! Oh, freebies!
Freebies. Two tickets going. You have to like and share the pinned to the top of the Facebook page Warhorse Post. You have to like it, and you have to share it, and ideally comment with a couple of friends on it, a couple of friends' names. So, yeah, you've got the chance to go to Liverpool to see Warhorse. They are in the upper circle seats. They're a decent view in the upper circles. Go and make a night out. Have a dinner there. Go and see the sights of Liverpool. Stay over. Have a romantic getaway. Whatever you want. But you've got tickets for Warhorse. And it's supposed to be incredible, the production of it. And if you do win it, let us know how you thought. What you thought about it. Yeah. Get a programme. I want a programme.
And the date is?
The date of this is the 16th of November, so that's a Thursday. Please only enter it if you can go. It's at 7:30 p.m. the show.
I will be doing a draw live here.
Yeah, on the first.
Should we use that bin down there, or do you think we should get a new one?
Yeah, we can use
bring a hat!
Should we bring a hat?
Bring one of your hats.
Bring a comedy hat.
Yeah, that'd work.
So that's mine at the moment.
Okay, Jack Owens says, great show.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jack. Thanks for being there. If you guys would like to join in a little bit, why not give us a call? You can get hold of us on 07874 055611. We need to get a proper phone system of such installed here instead of relying on this.
But yeah.
It works for now, so give us a call or join in via the comments.
Yeah.
You were talking about Timperley just before. I've noticed on some stories about Timperley Village having some new lights, new Christmas lights.
What do you think about the story about the new Christmas lights?
It's always, they've always been a little bit behind Altrincham.
Yeah.
Timperley's my hometown, so
yeah.
I need to go and have a look at that.
Well, they're going to put some beautiful lights around the Costa and all along the road, apparently, allegedly so. I might be completely wrong here. I want to see Frank Sidebottom dressed as Santa.
It does.
But with the proper beard. I think
he does pretty much every year.
Yeah.
And people might take them home as souvenirs.
Leave Frank's suit alone.
It'd be nice to see the new effort they're making for Christmas. Although I know that there's a couple of big companies and supermarket chains that have seen Timperley Village fit to film their Christmas ads in.
Oh, seriously?
I'm sure Iceland.
Oh,
filmed one a couple of years back, and there was another one, I can't remember what it was, but you notice all over Altrincham, those little luminous signs with codes on.
With LOC?
Yeah.
I have a little bit of information about that.
And they're doing a lot of filming around
here. I know exactly what it is.
And what source is it this time? Is it Peter Kay again?
No, it's a series for Netflix because they're filming it at my house.
Oh shit, you
are! No, actually, it's my family house that they're filming it at, but it's the new Netflix series called Safe, which had the guy from, what's his name? Not Dexter. Was it Dexter? What's his name? Michael C. Hall. Well, he's an actor, apparently it's a Hollywood actor called Michael C. Hall. I've got to say, I never watched Dexter, but yeah, he's using my family's house, and I'm not telling you where that is, for his actual house. And the story is actually based on his wife has died. I can tell you this because it's not actually an exclusive. I'm not letting the cat out of the bag. But he has two daughters. His wife has died. He has two daughters, and they go to live in an enclosed kind of, not a commune, but an enclosed village where it's very safe. And one of his daughters breaks out of there to go to a party one night, and then tragedy strikes. And I'm not sure how it strikes. I can't tell you what I've seen film-wise, but it should be exciting. It's one that I am going to watch because I just want to like spot and go, yeah, that's my mum and dad's house. But yeah, they're using that location now for quite a few times, and contrary to like any belief about it, they're using the dirty old donkey barn, which it's falling down, and they said that's perfect. Don't do it up, leave it how it is. There's planks falling down and everything. And my mum turned around to the producer and said, you can't use that, honestly, there's cobwebs hanging down. No, it's perfect. It's just what we want, it should be spooky. And they've got to come back, and one of the most stupid things they're doing is, because it's winter, all the leaves have come off the trees, They're going to put every single leaf back on the tree to make it look like summer.
Okay.
Which is ridiculous, but...
Are they going to paint them green as well?
I'm assuming so. I wouldn't like to be the person who did that.
Right.
That would be one hell of a job, to be honest, but...
Sort of like a job for Chris, to me.
Yeah. Chris was signing up for a new project. So... So yeah, that's a bit of juicy gossip for it. I'll try and get a photo next time we're filming if you want.
Yeah.
If you're interested. I've got to say, I don't know who it is.
Exclusive.
Doing it, but yeah, you can have, I'll try and do a little interview with him if you're interested. I've got to say, I don't know who he is, to be honest. I've watched Dexter.
If it turns out to be somebody famous, get an autograph and we'll do a competition.
I will. I'll even get a signed photo for all three of you.
That'd be cool.
Yeah.
Or it can go on the wall up there with that one of Chris and Sally from Coronation Street.
Oh, Sally Dimmer. Oh, Sally. She's lovely, Sally, isn't she?
Yeah, nice girl.
Yeah. Oh. Right, so
have
we got any more news?
Okay, well...
Is anyone going to call us?
It doesn't look like it, does it? Should we try it again? Would you like someone to try this time?
Yeah, let's look at the numbers.
Shall I write it bigger?
Yeah, please, clean the glasses. The number, if you want to call in and chat to us or ask us a question about anything Altrincham related, is 07874 055611. Give us a call, have a rant, ask us a problem. If you want Agony Uncle and Aunt here, go and ask us a problem.
Cause us a problem?
Yeah, I'm good at giving advice. Especially like, we want the juicy gossip, really.
Yeah.
Bring it on. Tell us the juicy gossip. You can even be anonymous if you want.
Okay.
Your phone's up. Oh, here we go.
We know who this is, so
okay.
We're going to check it. Hello there! Hello there! It's Chris and Joe.
Chris and Joe, can you hear us?
Obviously not, never mind.
Well,
thanks for that, Chris and Joe. The very first call goes pear-shaped, but...
It's alright.
I was just going to mention, you know where we're based here at A4 Studios in Altrincham, and I'd just like to give these guys a little bit of a plug, because they're doing some fantastic work for the community here. They're looking for your vote in the Arriva Community Awards. There's a post on the page that was posted a little earlier today about that. Please show these guys your support. They're doing great for underprivileged groups and people in the area. It's a big creative effort that they're putting in. The stuff that's going to come out of there is going to blow you away. Talking about the stuff that's in here, they're also holding an exhibition that's coming up on the 2nd of November called Curiosities. It's an exhibition to celebrate the curious and unusual in modern day art.
Is that Thursday?
I'm not sure what day it is. You would ask me that question, but I haven't written
I'm
it
so
down.
I'm so sorry. I'm just thinking because I'm going away on the 3rd, that's all. Yes, it is. It's
so,
Thursday.
Yeah, there's a preview night there on the 2nd of November. The last exhibition of house just closed. It was an exhibition called Walk the Line by Trafford College Art and Design students. The work's actually still up there. You've seen it, haven't you?
Yeah,
there's really some good stuff there. So get down, show them your support. If you'd like to submit your own work to an exhibition, there's an open call for artists for artwork on the theme of gender. Again, there's details on the page, we'll post further details, but the deadline for that will be the 23rd of December. It's a little way off yet, so bear it in mind, but please generally have a look through A4's post that we put on the page. You may be surprised what you find.
Mm-hmm.
There's some good stuff out there.
Do you know what? There's some really talented artists from South Trafford College. Trafford College. I know it's South Trafford because I went there to do art as well.
Are you old as well?
I'm
37. Shall we try and take Joanne's call?
Yeah, let's take Joanne's call.
Because this might be Chris. Chris would like to say hello. Hello there!
What's going on with the phone link? Oh no. Never mind. But yeah, as I was saying about South Trafford College, some really talented. I keep saying South Trafford, I'm sorry. It's always going to be South Trafford to me, as I'm sure it will be to many of you. Very talented artists, as there is in all the schools actually around the Altrincham Temple area. I mean, the stuff that's coming out of Loretto at the moment, and Alti boys, Alti girls, I mean, spectacular work, really impressive. And you know what, we'd love to see some of your work actually that you do. If you could submit us some photos, we'd love to do a gallery of them, you know. Show yourself off, show off the talent that you have.
Get involved, yeah.
Yeah. Do that, and we'd love to see some of your pieces in A4 as well, so it's worth doing. You might just be discovered.
Are you arty then?
I am quite arty, yeah.
Then what direction? What do you enjoy arty then?
Well, I was very good at doing kind of art at school, but I didn't do that direction. When I was super skinny, I was an ex-ballerina, and then I went to the West End, and sang in the West End when I was younger, and now we've got the Bowdoin Dance Academy, which is up in Bowdoin. And
Funnily enough,
it's in Wales. We've got that. I mean, I prefer being up here in the north teaching. I mean, we've got some talent around. Your kids are so talented, and they're so lacking in confidence. Some of them, really, it's staggering just the amount of talent that you've got out there, like real talent.
It's to be encouraged.
It is to be encouraged. I mean, I've got to say, I'm one of those people that don't celebrate mediocrity for the sake of it, like everyone gets a medal.
Yeah.
It's more, you do have those kids that usually aren't pushed to the front.
Non-competitive sports days, don't get me started on that sort of stuff.
Do you know what? Compete. I remember once my mum did the egg and spoon race, and whose mum was it? Might be Vicky Eccles, his mum was beaten and she kind of like elbowed her. My mum won! But she did have it stuck to blue tack on an egg on a spoon, and it's like,
you've got to learn how to lose before you know what it's like to win. Oh, yeah, it's as simple as that.
You do. But yeah, there is some talent. We would love to see your submitted entries at A4 as well. I'm sure we're going to be covering that as well.
I'm sure we will, yeah. I'm certainly knocked out by some of the stuff you see here. I love being based here.
Yeah.
It's got a nice feel about it. More and more creative people moving in all the time. Mm-hmm. We've got writers, artists, upholsterers, you name it, we've got it.
I need some upholstery.
It works for me.
Yeah. I'm actually also going around Altrincham at the moment. I'm trying out a lot of different cafes and restaurants, you might have noticed, like on the Instagram posts. So next week I'm probably going to be doing a piece on a very lovely little Japanese patisserie in Altrincham. I'm sure some of you have been. It's called Sweet Octopus. I'm going to bring in a few cakes for Andy to try as well.
Oh, okay.
So yes, we're going to be doing a little kind of taster session here as well. We'll wait till next Wednesday and I'll tell you what's going to happen then, but I think we should celebrate all the wonderful shops and cafes and everything around Altrincham, because there is a lot of wonderful things about this place, even the surrounding areas, but Altrincham, you know, it's really coming into its own, I think. I personally think so anyway. If you've got anything that you want to share with us, like if you're a shop owner or anything, or you know, you've got something going on, let us know. We'll come down and cover it if we can. Can't promise every time, but we'll try and do it if we can.
We'll see what we can do.
Yeah.
So, I think we're about there for tonight, Kate.
I think we are
Don't you? Yeah, I'm going to have to go and put my producer's hat on. Yeah. So, I'll say goodnight to you now. I will see you guys again on Sunday. I know Chris is trying to get a live out of Cornwall at the moment, but I know his mobile signal wasn't too good down there. Wi-Fi's a little bit spotty, but he seems to be having a good time back there in the 1920s, so...
Oh, I love Cornwall. Yeah. I just like cream teas.
We'll watch out for that off, Chris. Anyway, guys, thank you for being there tonight. I'll leave you in the capable hands of Kate to wrap up, and I'll see you guys again soon. Take care.
Oh, thank you, Altrincham, for tuning in. Hopefully I'll be here next Wednesday. Probably will be. Thanks very much, and we'll be doing the draw as well for Warhorse. Don't forget to enter. Take care. Bye.